So welcome to Microbial Concepts. So in this video we are going to study about monochrome staining, okay, a very basic staining technique which is taught to you when you start with your practicals and your theory in first year, okay. So after learning all the basics of staining, you will do monochrome staining and your professors, your teachers will teach you how to prepare a slide and how to observe under microscope, okay. So a video is also uploaded on basics of staining technique where all the definitions are explained. So you can watch that video on my channel. And now about monochrome staining. So it is a staining technique that is used in microscopy to enhance the contrast and visibility of specific structures or your sample. Okay. So monochrome staining is also known as simple staining. Okay, or direct staining, as in very few steps, that is in 2 to 3 steps your slide is prepared and it is ready to observe under microscope. And it is also known as positive staining, as the dye, the basic dye that we use in monochrome staining, it has positive charge on it which binds to the bacterial cell wall which is negatively charged. Okay, so the dye is positively charged, so the staining name of the staining technique is also positive staining. Now it utilizes a single stain, okay, so the name monochrome, mono is single, chrome is color, so single color, to highlight the desired features of our sample. Now the process in short, so we treat the sample with the chosen stain and we allow it to bind specifically to our desired structure, and then we remove any excess stain, we wash that, and then we observe our slide under microscope. Then about the results of staining, the culture that you are studying, that will get prominently colored and the surrounding or the background remains unstained or minimally stained. Then this high contrast, that is your culture is stained and your background is minimally stained, so this gives you a high contrast image when you observe under microscope, okay, and this makes visualization and identification analysis easier, okay. So about the simple stain, as we have seen in the previous slide, we also name this technique as simple staining or positive staining. So this is the basic dye, or these are the basic dyes. There are 2-3 dyes that you can use for monochrome staining. So these are basic dyes and also known as cationic dyes, which are either in alcohol solution or aqueous solution. Okay, that means they are diluted up to 1 to 2%. Now these are basic dyes, so they easily release OH minus ions and they accept H plus ions, due to which the simple stains, they are positively charged. Okay, so this is say safranin, a basic stain with positive chromophore group. So it has positive charge, so it will stain the bacterial cell. Now the bacterial cell wall, it has negative charge, so this chromophore group will bind to the bacterial cell wall and it will stain the bacterial cell. Okay, so this is how the principle of simple staining or monochrome staining is. Now the positive charge stain, it will firmly adhere to the negative bacterial cell wall, and this makes the organism colored and your background colorless. So let's go through the procedure. So under aseptic conditions, as you are handling a microbial culture, always remember, you even if you have to make a small smear, you have to do it under aseptic conditions, okay. Then you flame incinerate your wire loop and then you allow your smear to air dry properly. After that, after your smear is air dried, you cover that smear with methylene blue. For example, one of the dyes, that is methylene blue, is also used for monochrome staining. So you add that on your smear and you allow it to react for 1 to 2 minutes. After that, you need to wash the excess stain by using distilled water. So you can use wash bottle or you can wash it under running tap water as well. But the stream of water should be very low. Then use distilled water to gently wash off the excess stain. Also wash off any stain that got on the bottom of your slide, because you have to observe your slide under microscope, so that may interfere with your image. Okay, so you need to wash any stain that is on the bottom of your slide. Then this is extra step. Okay, in some textbooks you will find that iodine solution is added to set the stain and then it is washed off, but you can also skip this. Then you wipe the backside of your slide and you gently blot the smear area, okay, because we don't want to wash or wipe our smear completely, so we gently blot the smear area with paper towel. And then you first focus your slide under 10x under microscope, and then slowly you need to put a drop of immersion oil and then adjust to 100x, okay, and then you observe your slide. Now this is what you may see. If your culture is of cocci, then you are using crystal violet, then you may see image like this. And if you are using safranine and say you have rod shaped bacteria in your sample, then you may see something like this. So these are four stains which you can use for monochrome staining. First is methylene blue. Exposure time is 1 to 2 minutes. Crystal violet 20 to 60 seconds. Carbol fuchsin 15 to 30 seconds. And safranine around 30 to 60 seconds. Okay, so you can use any of these stains. Only one stain you have to use. Okay, and remember the exposure time. Max it is till 1 minute. So this was about monochrome staining. So I hope this video is helpful to you. Do give a thumbs up. Do like my video. Do share these videos with your friends and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.